Okay, hello everybody and welcome to my first New Game Plus run. We doing it. It's time. I think I'm gonna do this the... I don't know if I want to do it with region lock in place so that I have to finish a region before moving on to make it a little bit harder on myself. I don't know if I want to speed run it. I don't know. But what I do know is I don't remember what this mix is. What's that? What I do know is that this boss is dying. That's my first time doing that. What scripted death? What scripted death? Wait, so does that mean that this portal is active now? Wait, there's not a portal. The ground is fake! What?
Did you die?
Yeah! I fucking died! That is not real, bro. No way. Is it gonna put me? Oh, it's gonna show me the cutscene as if I died. I wonder if there was a grease or something I could have touched.
They're really out here trying to sell The Last of Us Part 1 for PS5 edition for $70.
Oh my god, dude. I can't believe. Alright, I'm skipping this cutscene. We've all played Elden Ring before. We all know what's going on here. I could just walk out right here. I could go down. I don't know, man. Do I want to go down and fight the other boss that's down here? No, I don't think I do. I think I'll just go out this. What's the tutorial boss for, anyway? Jesus Christ, dude. I can't believe I did that to myself. That's so funny to me. Oh, I got to keep my souls! Okay, so I had to die either way. Like, I had no choice but to try to do that. Okay, that makes me feel a little bit better. Let's go kill that uncleared tree spirit, huh? Let's see. What's the cost to level up right now? Is that enough souls? Probably not. Oh, that's right, I can't even level up, because right now I'm maidenless. Should we go get the maiden and the horse first? Yeah, let's go do that, guys. We're gonna cut to when I get the horse, come back, and then we'll do the unclarity tree spirit. Everybody, we are back at the Stranded Graveyard Grace, about to go tackle the unclarity tree spirit in the bottom of the first hero grave. Full transparency, this playthrough is about total and utter chaos. I am going to fuck everything. we are doing the accursed ending, arguably one of the worst endings in the game. In terms of, like, for everybody, we're gonna set the world on fire. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do the frenzied flame ending. I think the loathsome dung eater ending is also considered to be one of the bad ones because, you know, you're like poisoning the world, but, you know, I don't know because I haven't actually done it myself. I just know what I've heard. If you guys want to see one of those runs as well, let me know. Because I'd be down, if everybody wants to see more content, I'd be down to provide you. We could do the mending endings where we get like Fia's ending and fucking everything like that. Because there are certain runes that you can use to alter, like Fia's rune, the Dung Eater rune. Go play through, that's for sure. I just sat there and did the fucking let's get to it. I'm trying to summon my shit. Get extra golden seeds, and that banished knight ash ore automatically gets moved to my storage. Interesting. Interesting. Well, let's go get the dragon seal because I actually never did this in my OG run. I just didn't have the desire to. Because I actually killed that thing at base stats in my very first playthrough. And then had 15,000 runes and was like, I'm gonna go up here and quickly kill this guy, because there's no way he's gonna be harder than the tree spirit. Well, I was wrong. Very, very wrong. Oh, hello. Hello. I survived a hit from it! I survived a hit from the fucking chariot! How is that even a possibility? Character's so beefy can take hits from a turret. Or a chariot. I don't know why I call it a carriage. Communion seal. Very good. And now we'll go back to Ray.
Luckily, me. Are you familiar with you may also that? It will lead you to even if it.
Yeah, well, whatever you say, guy. Broken to use the mimic. Like, I have no problem using a game mechanic to my advantage, but like, it almost feels wrong. I'm gonna, you know, before we cut to the next thing, let's go ahead and kill Agil. Agil of the Lake. Why not? Alright, I guess I'll just fast forward from here to one of the cave bosses. We'll go cave hopping, we'll do all the lesser area stuff, and then we'll go ahead and do the, we'll do Stormvale. I think we will do the region lock, just to kind of appreciate what the game has to offer, at a little bit of a more reasonable base. Okay, drum roll, please. Place your bets in the comments. Which cave do you think we went to first? Which boss is behind that door? You'll find out right now. Go ahead and comment below. Tell me. Say for... Now, I'm going to do this a couple times in this video, so bet number one. Hit. So when you comment, do bet one, and then whatever boss you think it is. Alright, here we go. If you said Stone Digger Troll, you were correct. Now I know what you're probably thinking. You're probably thinking, oh, is this bet number two? No. If you have any common sense, you clearly know I went from one to the other, so you guys already know that this is gonna be patches. Because I think you guys are smarter than the average bear. Welcome to the picnic basket, you know?
Well, well, well.
Yeah. Happen right now.
What a shit show.
Sorry, Patches. I know you're a fan favorite. Personally, one of my favorites. The first playthrough I did when you showed up, I was so happy. I was like, oh wow, they brought Patches back, and it's not a Dark Souls game, technically. Like, it's a Souls game, but it's not, you know, like. Makes me sad to do that, but I'm not getting kicked over the edge when we go to Volcano Manor and all that other stupid shit that you do. I'm here to bring about the end of the world. Okay. Again, this is not the second bet of the video. I want everybody to just, you know, we all know that if I did the one and then Patches and then the other, this is gonna be, you know, right down the same line. So let's just get right into it. Okay, here we are. This is bet number two, so I want everybody to comment. Bet two, and then what boss you think is in this cave? Or catacomb, I think this is a cave. Anyway, do bet two, and what boss you think is behind this door? And without further ado, let's get into it. If you guessed the Guardian Golem, you were correct. If you didn't, better luck next time. Well, I'm not gonna try to do that again. All right, on to the next one. Next cave I do, or catacomb I do, whichever it may be, that will be the final bet. We're gonna do bets 2 and 3 back to back, and then the rest of this video, you guys can just enjoy the show. All right, see you in a second. Okay, everybody, so I actually was wrong. There was one more catacomb really close to where I was at. So this is not going to be bet 3 in the comments. This is just kind of like, it's on the way before I fast traveled out. I figured it was just best to get this over with while I'm here. This guy really is some shit. He's going to die before 20 minutes up, so as far as I'm concerned, the fight's already over. And just like that, first Black Knight of the game is Shadow. And a death root. Nice. Easy mode, man. New Game Plus. So far, my first impression of New Game Plus is it might be a lot easier, like, I mean, infinitely easier than the original playthrough, but I'm not having any less fun. Like, I'm thoroughly enjoying myself. I'm definitely going to be implementing the region lock. So, obviously, by the title, you might know that by now. But yeah, I think I'm just going to finish out the rest of Limgrave before I push on. So, alright, I'll see you guys at Bet 3. Okay. Alright, everybody. I know what you're thinking. There's no fog door here. What are you doing? This is bet number 3. What's on that side of the door? If you guessed the demi-human duo, you were correct. Genuinely easy mode. Over with. Alright. That was bet number 3. I won't do any more bets this video. Just enjoy the ride as we cruise through the rest of Limgrave. Here we go again. Another catacomb. On the ball. To be fair, like, I haven't done anything worth a shit yet, but Elden Ring has an easy mode, and it's called New Game Plus. Here we are, at another boss. Another very easy boss. But I just enjoy this game so much. There's no point in not fighting. Even if I'm getting duplicates of things I don't need, I just... Elden Ring. Alright. We are here at the first ever ghoul of the game. I don't know if it's ever ghoul, ever goal, ever jail. I've heard people pronounce this thing all sorts of ways, man. I am what they call ignorant. So if you guys know the proper pronunciation of these ever goals, ever jails, ever G-A-O-Ls, I don't know. Okay? You guys let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, just enjoy the show of me crapping upon the first postman. I use all this glass. I'm sorry, y'all had to do that. Go ahead and comment below telling me that, I'm a potato. Another boss fight. This one is just Pumpkin Man, the guard selling. Literally, it took 10 seconds tops. Here we are at the second ever ghoul, ever jail, ever whatever you want to call it. Let's go ahead and get right into it. Excuse me. Ooh. Oof. That hurt a little bit. I ain't gonna lie. Thank you. are at yet another Everghoul, Evergill, Everghoul, Goal, Jail, Bale, Kale, whatever the fuck. I don't know, bro. We out. Here we go again. It's time for this boss fight to begin. Got a feeling that you'll not make it out. Store. After this boss fight, I will have done everything in Limgrave except for Castle Morn, Margit the Fell, and Godrick the Grafted. So you will be seeing three actual storyline boss fights. I guess technically the Castle Morn one isn't like storyline, like main storyline. Close enough to me, though. I mean, either way, it's gonna die. So, but for now, let's go ahead and kill the Watchdog again. My depth perception. was there. Here I am at Castlemorn, about to end the Misbegotten Beast. I'm guessing it takes really good. I could dual wield Game of Thrones swords now. God damn, dude. New Game Plus is so much fun. I am cruising. Alright, let me make it nighttime real quick. Can't move on into the castle until I do this. Almost forgot about it. Do I have to talk with him first?
Seems burnt. Let me ask, are you here? Does your despite? Yes, yeah, takes me any all I know. Now's the time. No.
Do I have to kill Morgott or Godric first? I have to buy something from him?
There. There's a mementos of a fine tale. That's how I feel. It grants meaning.
I'll just wait. Still on that, even though I already have it. This. Talk with him. Here we go. I feel like I really don't need this cooperator. I don't really need to summon Ragier. I will. Just because I can. But let's see this cutscene. Margit the Fell.
Foul tarnished. In search of the Elden Ring. Emboldened by the flame of ambition.
Brother, you may as well break open that cane now and use that iridescent sword you got, because otherwise, you're dead as hell. And even if you use it, you're dead as hell. Oh, what's funny is I can use Ragier in my mimic if I want to. Kinda hits, though. Kinda. seeing Lindeldog. Seeing Lindeldog.
Smoldering with thy meager flame. Cower in fear of the night. The hands
I am the night, bro.
Omen shall brook thee no quarter.
Please. Please, whatever you say there, coward.
Mighty dragon, thou'rt a true-born heir. Lend me thy strength, O kindred. Deliver me unto greater heights. Well. Of dragons, lend me thy strength.
Everyone, before I sign off for this video, I just wanted to say I'm sorry for my microphone being bugged during the Godric the Grafted boss fight. I was in the middle of editing and actually had to get rid of my previous outro and the past several minutes were, I don't know if it was corrupted or if it was just my microphone not working or what, but that's why I wasn't talking during the boss fight. Anyway, I just wanted to take the second to thank everybody who came to watch this video. Thank everybody for the support over the past couple videos. I really started this YouTube channel just to kind of keep it as a little time capsule for me and watch my own greatest hits, as I like to call them, and funny moments that I enjoyed. And it's been really cool lately to get hundreds of views in the past couple of days on some videos. So if you guys really like it, then be sure to, you know, subscribe, hit the bell, maybe even drop a like or a comment if you enjoyed. And I don't make any money off of these. I never really intended for this to be anything more than my own little keepsake, so just thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. This is cool. So, I'm glad that not only am I getting enjoyment out of this, but for a little while, you know, so are you guys. And that's all I could ever really ask for. So, thank you everybody. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day or evening, wherever you are, depending on what time of the day it is. And, you know, yeah. Thank you guys again. Peace.